day, everybody. This is Nelca Roco again. And while I'm busy working on my warehouse lighting design techniques course for my Udemy courses, one of our friends asked me about the chandelier. Okay, his name is Amid Sabri. He said, "Hey Nelca, I'm amazed with your lighting tutorials on YouTube. Blah blah blah." But I have a problem with how to get the chandeliers in Dialux. Okay, so you did say from where to get those chandeliers, but you did not say how to import them or enter them into Dialux. So please help me. All right, okay, I think he's referring either to this one. This is one of the restaurant project that I created and I use a chandelier object. Look at this one, amazing, right? Or maybe he's talking about this one. So this is a villa with with a cute chandelier inside, like this one. Okay, so this is an object, and you can get, you can get these chandeliers to either two websites. One is from archive3d.net. or to this 3D warehouse SketchUp. Okay, all you have to do is go and search chandelier, type it here in the search tab, and then yeah, you can have a chandelier here. And once you selected what you want, just click on that and then download it. Yes, just download it. Make sure you, okay, you need to sign in. You can select the 2016 or 17 version, whatever SketchUp file you have. And then for this one, you just need to select it. Most of the objects here in this archive 3d.net are already objects, so you can just download it and import it to your Dialux Evo. So once you selected this one, you either edit it in Pick and Planner or 3D SketchUp software. Okay, so if you want to know more, I created a tutorial on how to import these 3D files into your Dialux Evo and use it as your chandelier. Okay, so this is an object. Okay, and how to import, save file, and then import, and then furniture file, and then look for the 3DS file that you saved either from 3D Warehouse SketchUp or 3darchive.net. All right, and then you will get it and you can import it now. See, like this one, there you go. And you may be asking, how are you going to light it up? So there are another ways on how to do that, like say for example this one. So I have the 3D object. So this is an object, this is the chandelier, and I selected this lamp. This is a bare lamp from Vitak, and if you want to get some LED lamps, go and look for lamps here at lumsearch.com from Dialux. So you'll have this bare lamp, you see this one, or from this bulb, the 7-watt bulb. Look at this one, and then you can import it into Dialux and use this lamp as a regular lamp, like this lamp, right? You see, I used the VTAC, and then you can use that one now in your chandelier to make it glowing light. There you go, it's not that much. Alright, so that's it. It's very easy. So get your chandeliers from this tool website, SketchUp, 3D Warehouse SketchUp, and 3D Archive 3D.net. And then make sure you save a 3DS file. If you don't know how to convert the SketchUp file into that 3DS, go and search my other YouTube on how to use Picon Planner to convert the SketchUp file into that 3DS file. And then from there, you can now import it and use it in your Dialux Evo. Alright, so if you're confused, go and check those videos that I mentioned, and then you are good to go. Alright, so see you again on the next video, and I hope that you check this new course, the Warehouse Lighting Design Techniques, and also my Landscape Lighting Design Techniques ebook. Okay, so that's it. So see you again on the next video. Bye.